Before we get into making a preloader, which is what we see here, let's first talk about the most important thing. Should you use a preloading screen of any type? Some people say yes, others say never. The answer is, it's up to you. Page loads can go pretty fast. Your preloader might look ridiculous if it's only up for a quarter of a second. On the other hand, maybe you've designed a page that takes several seconds before it's presentable. Regardless, if you want to set up a preloader, here's a quick way to do it. 1. We'll design our preloader. 2. We'll set our initial state. And 3. We'll make sure the preloader goes away once the page is loaded. Number 1. We'll drag in a div block from the add panel, and we'll drag it right into the page body. This div block will be the main container for our preloader, so we'll create a class and name it preloader. Let's make some adjustments. First, we'll enable flexbox, and we'll justify and align its children to the center. Second, we'll adjust the positioning, setting the position to fixed. We'll make sure to select full so it fills up the whole viewport, and we'll set the z-index to some obscenely high number. This means it'll appear on top of all other elements. Finally, let's set a background color. We can choose a color from the color picker right here. And of course, we can drag in anything. Anything can show up on page load. If it's a huge GIF or a video or something, it'll probably slow down the page load and serve as an anathema to the whole spirit of the preloading thing. So it's up to you. We've just dragged in a text block and we wrote loading. And that's it. That's the basic design. The bouncing ball, the one from the beginning, is taught in the full guide on Webflow University. So check out the link to that in the description and feel free to skip over to that if you want to build it. Let's set our initial state. Now, the first thing we want to do after our design is done, we've simply put the word loading here for now, is set the display in the style panel here to none. Why? Because we want to be able to edit on the page without a giant div block covering our work. Now, notice the preloader div block is still selected, and we'll go over to interactions where we can add a trigger. We'll make sure the trigger is the page loading, and we have two options here. We can set it when the page starts loading, or we can set it when the page finishes loading. We'll want to go with the second option. Let's create a new timed animation here, and let's name it. We're giving a name to this animation. And this is where we can set our initial state. Even though we set the display to none in the style panel, we can set our display back to flex under hide show, and we'll simply choose flex. This makes it visible again. And to make it the initial state, we just flick the switch. That's it. Part 2 complete. And now for the final part. The initial state controls what everything looks like when the page first comes up. We're going to make our preloader disappear once the page finishes loading. We're going to do this in two steps. One, we'll add a new point, a new action that sets the opacity to 0%. We want this to occur fairly quickly, so let's change the duration to drop that a bit. And two, after that, we want to set our display setting to none. After fading out, after the opacity hits 0, we'll hide it. We'll set our display setting to none. Now, if we want to ensure that the preloader shows up for a set amount of time, a minimum, we can go back to the first action, the opacity change, and we can set it to occur after, say, half a second. That means even after the page loads, it'll hold for a half second before starting to disappear. And that's it. We create our design, set our initial state, and animate it out. We do all this on page load when the page finishes loading. That's setting up a preloading animation.